Welcome. Today we are going to work on a little bit of under the sea action with a jellyfish. And I'm just painting this as I go. I have not practiced it, so this should be interesting. All right, the first thing I'm doing is taping my paper down. I'm working horizontal. You can work horizontal or vertical for this one if you'd like to. I am going to aim to possibly fit two jellyfish in here, or maybe some undersea plant life. We'll see. But my tape is going halfway on the paper, halfway on my desk. And if you don't want to tape something to your desk, you can just tape it to another piece of paper, to the back of a magazine. This will just help keep your paper from warping. And I'm using washi tape, so it doesn't stick too badly. We should be good to go. All right, well, let's get on in and start this jellyfish. I'm gonna do jellyfish number one. And you don't have to use a pencil. I just want you to see where I'm going with the shape of this. So it's kind of a, it's like a bell shape maybe. And then I'm kind of gonna have some wobbly shape happening here along the edge. So let's go ahead and just fill that in with water. I'm gonna paint wet on wet for this jellyfish. So I'm just gonna paint, and if you don't wanna do the pencil part, you can just go straight in and make this shape with water. So I just wanna get it a little bit wet. Really make a nice little rounded dome, like the top of a little cartoon ghost or something. So I've got that all filled in with water. And I'm gonna come in, I think this jellyfish is gonna be kind of reddish and purple. So I'm gonna come in with a little bit of red, but I wanna water it down really nicely. I don't want this color to be dark at all. So I'm gonna come in with red, and I'm gonna stay just on one side and kind of touch that red all down one side. And I'm just gonna let the paint do what it's gonna do. Now on the other side, I'll use my purple. So this purple is pretty dark, so we really, truly need to water it down. Super watering down the purple. Okay, and then same deal over here with the purple. So I'm putting the purple on the other edge. And I'm kinda just gonna let it play. And I want to leave a little bit of, like, I'm dotting, I'm not purposefully mixing. And I'm going to dry out my brush because I want to lift a little bit of that paint off. I feel like there's a little too much paint here. So I'm going to lift, just take some paint off through the center and make it very, very light. Oh, and hairs are coming out of my brush, so that is always a good time. Are they? Maybe my paper just was scratched a little bit, I guess. I think that's what's going on. Okay, so then I'm gonna let this be just for a minute. And we're gonna think about the clumpy parts that come out kind of through the center of the jellyfish. So these in my jellyfish, let's see, maybe blue? You can use any colors for these jellyfish that you want. You don't have to use the same colors I'm using. I try to use colors that, oh, I didn't get blue, I got purple. I try to use colors that, when they mix, don't make brown. So like not green and purple together. Or not yellow and purple. What am I doing? Blue, so this is like a bluish purple. Okay, so for these parts of the jellyfish, like the kind of really gloppity parts, we're gonna make little squiggly lines, but that are kind of messy and come down to a point. So at the point of them, I'm just gonna make dots. So this messy gloppy business that looks like what is even going on here is exactly what we want. And I am just gonna like barely touch it to the edge of the jellyfish. And then we'll do a couple more of those. So just gloppy, we wanna see the contour on the edge. And then we get down to the bottom. And these don't have to be like any particular shape. A jellyfish is an incredibly fluid, floaty being. So they don't have to be one particular shape. And then I'll maybe put like another little tiny short one over here. But this can be real knobby and irregular and just all around sort of weird. And it's fine. So we're gonna kind of just let this be for a moment. You can put some darker splotches here and there if you feel like it. That's what I'm just doing right now. I might get a little bit of that purple come in here too. I'm just gonna add a little purple to some spots that are already wet. Gonna let that be for a moment, and what will end up happening is we'll have all these floofy swirly things coming off this jellyfish. But for now we've kind of got some time, so let's come over here and we'll make a fun little piece of seagrass, and I will show you how to do that. So I'm using some green, and I'm watering it down because we don't want anything too dark here. And if you don't have one of these, you can use the lid that your paints came in, like the lid of your paint thing, or you can use just a white plate. All right, so I'm going in with a little green first, and I am just gonna come up here right here, and I'm squishing down and pulling up. So there's one little piece, and then I'm going to dip in the yellow. And I'm starting with a tip, and I'm squishing down, and I'm coming up and pulling that brush up. And see how that's kind of fun, like the colors are getting mixed. And we'll go back into green, same deal. Squish down and pull up. And these can be any shape you want them to be. Squish down, pull up. It's kind of fun to pull not with your wrist but kind of with your shoulder. So squish down and pull up. And see how that one just goes straight across. We're just breaking all the rules here. So I'm gonna squish down and pull up. So this can all just kind of squish down and pull up. This can all just kind of cross over. Be kind of whatever you want it to be. This is just our little seagrass. I want this to blend a little better, so I'm going to add water down here and through here. All right, so our jellyfish top is starting to dry, so we can go back to these colors that we started with on our jellyfish. And what's going to be important is that we leave some of these light parts showing through. So we don't want to get too dark, but I am going to make this paint a little bit darker. So we are just going to come in and we're going to dab some dark on this side. You're kind of going, you still want that wet on wet look. And we are just slowly adding little dabs of color. Then I'll go into my purple. And we'll kind of make some of these reds and purples and blues get a little mixed together. But we just want this surface to look really irregular. If you have salt, this is a great application for salt. So I'm going to come down here because I'm thinking my jellyfish has kind of got like that backside of itself too. So I'm going to come in and I'm trying not to touch those sections. I'm just adding them in between. Some blue up here at the top. So let's keep that light part that we have through there. I'll add some purple over here to the edge. This is kind of a lot about layering. So we want to come in and make sure that we have a little bit of lightness, a little bit of layering. Just you can pretty much add any colors in here that you want. I'm gonna even try like some yellow just to give it a little bit of interest where it's wet there. Okay, man, I'm breaking my own rules. I said not yellow and purple because they make brown, but here I am doing that. So I'm trying to leave some dry spots and not get all of those spots. So this blue is kind of drying, so I'm going to come back in here with a little bit thicker of blue. And I'm just going to kind of dot. I'm still pretty wet. Just going to dot around. So our main goal here is to be really layery. We want a lot of layers. Alright, so that's pretty good. We're going to let this dry. And you can fan it if you have something nearby, like a fan. Another piece of paper will work really, really well. So just go ahead and get this stuff drying. Have a hair dryer, you can come in and dry with a hair dryer. Also, we know that if we have water sitting and we don't want it to all just sit there and dry, we can come with our brush and roll over and lift some of that paint. It's like just a great little paint vacuum. And we're still gonna get these really cool colors. So anywhere that you want to lift some paint, run your dry brush over it. All right, that's a little better. So I'm gonna go ahead and dry with my little dryer. I just want to get this nice and dried out. And we just want to give that illusion that light is coming through the dome of that jellyfish. This isn't important that this over here is dry, but I'm going to dry it just for fun. Because I can. So now on our jellyfish, I'm gonna come over and I'm gonna start adding these tentacles. And these can really be any or all of the colors, but they need to, the paint needs to be thicker. We don't want that wash. We want it to be a little thicker. So I'm gonna thicken this paint up a little bit. I'm gonna get some red, and I think I'm also gonna have some purple tentacles. So I'm gonna darken up my red and my purple. I don't want it gummy, but but I do want it a good consistency that it's going to be kind of a darker look. Still translucent, but darker. All right, so this is where it's fun. And this is where you're not going to do this with your wrist. You're going to kind of move your shoulder and really just ziggy-zaggy through there. So this ridge right here is where we're going to start our tentacles. And the ones in the middle are going to be much longer. So just the very tip of that brush. And you are just making these differently squiggled, kind of long tentacles. And these are kind of dark. I think I might, if I could control it, go a little bit lighter than that. A few red ones. You can see I messed up there, but we're not going to worry about it. And it doesn't matter if they cross over. Water this purple down a little bit more. A few more purples. There we go, that's looking good. You can have some that kind of go out to the side. You can have some that cross over. Whatever the water in your ocean is doing is fine. And it might be fun to come and put some kind of just strings of dots through here. And this just gives that illusion of an even, maybe an even finer strand that is winding around. So that is fun. And you can put other, I'm gonna put some purple dots as well, I think, because I like it. I'm a fan of the dots. I think it just gives it a little bit more randomness. Maybe above your skill level. Don't stress yourself out trying this if it's too much for you. Some bigger dots. See, now you don't even know I messed up right there, so that's kind of cool. So here's my jellyfish. It's getting a little busy, so I'm gonna stop because I'm not very good at stopping, but I'm gonna try to be good at it today. And then we just need to kind of go back in and add a little bit of contouring to the edge of our jellyfish. So I'm gonna dip in red and purple and make a little mixture. And this is pretty watery, but what I want to do is come around this bottom edge and kind of add a little bit of contouring so that you can see the front part of my jellyfish, and that it is the front. And then we can add some easy stripes. And these are super duper light. Rinsing my brush completely, and I am going to start above here, and I'm going to kind of blend this boundary that I made. So it's a little bit of a blendy work, but only with water. Again, I'm putting water above it and kind of blending. This music is getting like really dramatic for us here. Just kind of tap the tip of that brush kind of up and over that line. Not so pronounced. And then with this paint that's still on our brush, we can come in and put like little lines like this through. And I think I'm gonna roll a little bit of it off that direction so it'll look a little lighter and more see-through. So there's that jellyfish. It might be looking like a blob of nothing right now. That's okay if that's how you feel. I'm kind of feeling that way, but I know when I look at it in a little bit, it'll be better. So I'm gonna go mess with this plant a little bit more. So I'm gonna get some green and put some more layers over top of it. Just in that same motion that we did before. Just making flat at the bottom, and then as we come up, let it get thinner. All right. So here is what we've got so far. Let's think about what else we might put in here, or if it's time to stop. You can add more coral, more seagrass, more of anything that you'd like, really. I think I'm going to add a little bit of sand at the bottom. And if your jellyfish hits the bottom, you don't have to do this, and I would advise against it. But I'm just going to take some yellowish brown and kind of run across the bottom here just to give it a little boundary. Trying to touch my plant very much, and I'll just give it a little bit over here, but I'm leaving some white space. I think I'm going to throw some salt on the wet parts of my plant because that's going to look kind of interesting. And then for my jellyfish, I think I'm going to go back in here and add a little bit of water, and then I'm going to throw some salt on that jellyfish as well. We just want to make sure that we're leaving the brighter spots open. We don't want to paint back over those. And then I'm going to add a tiny bit of salt and let it dry and see what happens. I think that's going to look really good. Okay. So now I'm going in and I'm gonna put some water in the background. Now I'm not gonna touch everything that's here, I'm just gonna sketch in. And I know it might sound funny, you'd be like, this is watercolor paints, how do we sketch? Well, that's what I'm gonna show you. So this is gonna be a mixture of green and blue and yellow. So yellow. That is ugly, that's not the watercolor that I want. There. Now we're getting a little more aqua, but I want even more blue. Oh, there we go. That's a pretty aqua color. Okay. So you may only have 8 paints, but you can still make lovely colors. All right. So I'm just going to get my brush and I'm going to make some downward strokes from the top. I'm going to keep adding water. I don't really want to touch my jellyfish. I'm just getting the tip of my brush, and even though it's kind of dry, that's okay. And for my plant, I don't want to go back and forth over that plant. I just want to kind of like, I'm brushing over it, but I'm trying not to carry any of that green up here. Just adding water up here. And then while this is wet, put some salt in there. And that's gonna make it look all cool and salty and just exactly the way I like it. So I don't wanna smear my jellyfish. So I'm trying not to touch it. I smeared a little bit, that's okay. I don't want to completely obliterate my jellyfish. Maybe it would be a better way to say this. So I don't want to touch my jellyfish with this little wash that I'm throwing in here. I just want to keep it washy and light. Not touching my jellyfish, most importantly. And I'm trying to keep all of my strokes downward, which is what's a little challenging about this. So if you're not comfortable with it, you don't have to put a background in. You don't have to do anything. You can just leave your jellyfish and it doesn't have to have a colored background. Or you can wait till your jellyfish is like kind of completely dry and you can go back in and put the background. But for the sake of finishing up this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I do what I do. So I want my corners to be darker, and then the middle of the page will be lighter. The corners and kind of the top of the page to be darker. And then at the end, we'll come and like throw some little speckles in here that'll bring it all together. I'm trying so hard not to touch this jellyfish, and it's like the harder I try, the more I get close to touching it. I hope that's entertaining everyone. It's kind of entertaining me. And every time I have a little wet piece of place I've painted, I'm gonna throw some salt on it. It looks like this part didn't get very salty, so I'm gonna re-wet it, throw a little salt on there. There, y'all. So close. And wherever this is wet, you can always just go like dab little spots of color in if you want to. This is just how I paint. This is my style very much. Just to go back and dab color on places. If I want that background to look a little bit kind of random. Little salt down there. And then by putting salt where it's water, I'm gonna add a little more water so that the salt works. Some of these places were dried. So then if I want to, I can add a little more of the dark blue to places and it'll just kind of seep in. So it's kind of just seeping. I'm not blending it purposefully. I just want that top part to be a darker blue for it to barely work its way down. Just wanted to have that fun look that, I mean, only watercolor can give us. I am playing with fire right here because some of this paint is still wet. Taking my chances, y'all. Okay. You don't have to get in these nooks and crannies if you feel like you're just gonna mess something up, but I'm taking my chances. This is kind of dry as I'm coming in and contouring around my jellyfish. Filling in any little tiny places. And this is a very unimportant step because, as you know, it already looks pretty good. I'm just very bad at stopping. So I'm keeping going. I'm just kind of dotting this darker blue at places close to the top. All right. And lastly, this one's gonna have speckles. And I think I'm gonna do blue speckles because that mixes well with pretty much everything on here. It mixes with my jellyfish. So I'm just loading my brush with blue paint. I have another, it's very thin, and I have another, and I am dropping some sprinkles all over. So these little speckles, wherever your paper is dry, they're gonna stay dots, but wherever your paper is wet, they're gonna blend in. It's kind of fun. Gives us a little more depth. I'm gonna throw some purple speckles in. I mean, what have we got to lose? And I really want to get them all over this body of this jellyfish because I want it to look kind of translucent, like you can see through it, and I think that's gonna help. So, all right, so I'm done. I'm gonna stop because if I don't, I'm gonna overdo it. And I'm gonna let this dry and I'm gonna come back to you and I'll untape it. It's gonna be so awesome. All right.